Good morning. I'm Leland Moore. I've been a member of Christ Church now for over 30 years. This COVID virus has turned all of our lives upside down, especially or including our church life. I really miss things like worship, prayer, communion, and almost most of all, fellowship with each one of you. It's been really hard not to get hugs and be hugged, to give hugs, to just share and be together. So obviously we've had to find other ways to stay focused on God. And David asked me if I would tell you how I'm trying and working to be focused on God. So that's what I wanted to share with you today. The key for me is one word. It's a simple word. It's called routine. It's very important, no matter what you're doing, to maintain routine because everything is upside down. So I wanted to share my routine with you. My wife Carmen and I get up every morning between 5 and 5:30, 7 days a week pretty much. And we get our coffee and we have our quiet time, sometimes together when it's not so quiet, but most of the time we separate so that we can focus on God. I start off basically by playing a worship song. It might be the prayer, might be Hallelujah, it may be Waymakers, but it's something that really gets me into worship mode, and I can raise my hands if I want to, and I can join in the words, or I can just pray to God. But that sets me up, and then I go into prayer. And David shared with us a few weeks ago when he gave 2 sermons on prayer about the Lord's Prayer. And I wanted to share that with you. I say the Lord's Prayer from beginning to end. And I've done that for so long that a lot of times I don't think about what I'm saying. So then I go back and I do it in pieces. And I might say, Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. And then I pray, Father, you are holy, holy, holy. Lord God Almighty, there is nobody like you, Lord. And thank you that you love me so much. And then I might pray, Thy kingdom come, Thy will be done. And I think, Lord, we need your kingdom here today. And we need to do your will. Will you help us? Will you shine the light and help us? And I might even pray in prayer language some, which God gave me when I was saved. It might be or whatever. Do I know what I'm saying? No, but the Holy Spirit does, and He's communicating that to God, and He's saying maybe something I'm leaving out that God wants to hear and needs to hear. And I go through the whole prayer like that, and that gets me more in relationship with Him and gets me praying in the Spirit. And then I shift into devotionals. I have 2 devotionals that I use right now. One is the Upper Room. It's pretty simplistic. My wife and I both use it. But when I was growing up, my dad and mother collected the children every night, and my dad would read the Upper Room and the Bible passage that went with it. So I've carried that forward now. It's very familiar, but it's very comfortable, and I love the stories that the people tell. I've shifted around with the other ones, but right now I'm reading one that was given to me not long ago, and it's called Walking with a Limp. I'm about 75 days into it, and it's remarkable. It's done by a local guy, and it's been really, really special. So it doesn't matter what your devotionals are, but it's important to have something that guides you. Next, I get into my Bible readings, and I use the chronological Bible that I bought from the church. And I decided I don't want to do this in a year. I want to do this slowly. I want to read every footnote. I want to think about it. So I read a little bit in the Old Testament, maybe a page or two in the footnotes, and then I read a little bit in the New Testament. And then I pray about them. I say, God, do you have a word for me? And I'm a journaler. I've been journaling now for 20 years. I've got over 10 books of journals now that I hope someday my children will see when I'm gone, and maybe it'll help them or guide them in their faith. But I write that down. And maybe once or twice a week is all I do it, but I do it. And then at the end of that, I pray. And that's pretty much it. The next thing in our routine is my wife and I go for a 30-minute walk 5 to 7 times a week. And we'll talk, and we'll talk about what we read, and we'll just visit. But it's part of keeping that routine. The second thing that I do that really helps me is I've been with a group of 10 men for about 20 years. We meet every Tuesday morning from 6 to 7:30. We typically would have coffee and get together, but with COVID, we talk on the phone. We don't see the faces, but we do talk. And we share. It's a special time of accountability because of the confidentiality that we maintain. We share, and we know things about them that most people don't. And we pray for each other. At the end of it, it's really special. When we were together, we would hold hands and go around the circle, and each one would pray individually the things on his heart. And then the host at the end, after he prayed, would lead us in the Lord's Prayer together. So now we do that on the phone. Each one prays individually in order, and then we do the Lord's Prayer. And the other thing that's really important, I realized about 8 years ago that I needed an accountability partner. I was helping other people be accountable, but nobody was taking care of me. And so I asked Father Ken if he would be my accountability partner. And so every Thursday morning at 6:30, Ken is at my house. We maintain social distancing, but we share coffee and we just talk to each other about families, about the church, about health issues or just whatever. And then we pray together, and we pray for each other, and we pray for the church. So those are the things that really make a difference for me. They are routine. I still work mostly from home, but that also gives me routine. And so I think whatever you do with your faith walk, you need to marry that with other things that keep you in a routine, that make you want to get up in the morning, that make you want to have a good day and a focused day. And that's kind of what I wanted to share. So I hope and I pray that this will help you. Thank you.
From the dead, so we sing. us worship our King. Come, let us bow at His feet. He has done great things.
Yes.
See what our Savior has done. See how His love overcomes. He has done great things.
Yes, He has.
He has done great things.
Oh, hero.
Oh, hero of heaven, you conquer the grave. You free every captive and break every chain. Oh, God, you have done great things. We dance in your freedom, awake and alive. Oh, Jesus, our Savior, your name lifted high. Oh, God, you have done great things. Been faithful through every storm. You'll be faithful forevermore. You have done great things,
yeah. And I know.
And I know you will do it again. For your promise is yes and amen. You will do great things,
yeah.
'Cause God, you do great things. Oh, hero of heaven, you conquered the grave. You free every captive and break every chain. Oh, God, you have done great.
We
dance in your freedom, awake and alive. Oh, Jesus, our Savior, your name lifted high. Oh, God, you have done great things.
Yes.
And hallelujah, God, above it all. Hallelujah, God, unshakable. Hallelujah, you have done great things.
Yes.
And hallelujah, God, above it all. Hallelujah, God, unshakable. Hallelujah, you have done great things.
So sing hallelujah.
And hallelujah, God, above it all. Hallelujah, God,
unshakable.
Hallelujah, you have done great things. You've done great things. Oh, hero of heaven, you conquer the grave. You free every captive and break every chain. Oh, God, you have done great things. We dance in our freedom, awake and alive. Oh, Jesus, our Savior, your name lifted high. Oh, God, you have done great things. You have done great things. Oh, God, God, you do great things.
Come out of sadness from wherever you've been. Come broken hearted, let rescue begin. Come find your mercy, oh sinner, come near. Earth has no sorrow that heaven can't heal. Earth has no sorrow that heaven can't heal. So lay down your burdens, lay down your shame. All who are broken, lift up your face. Oh, wanderer, come home. You're not too far. Lay down your hurt, lay down your heart. Come as you are. There's hope for the hopeless. There's hope for the hopeless. And all those who stray, come sit at the table. Come taste the grace. There's rest for the that endures. Earth has no sorrow that heaven can't cure. So lay down your burdens, lay down your shame. All who are broken, lift up your face. Oh, faithful one, so unchanging, ageless one, you're my rock and peace, Lord of all, I depend on you. I call out to you again and again. Call out to you again and again.
Faithful one, so unchanging, ageless one, you're my
in times of trouble. You lift me up when I fall down. All through the storm, your love is the faithful one, oh faithful, so unchanging. He's the ageless rock, ageless one. You're my rock of peace, Lord of all. Lord of all, I depend. Who do we call out to? I call out to you again and again. I call out to you again and again. You're my rock. You are my rock in time. Yes. You lift me up when I fall down. All through the storm, your love is the anchor. My hope is in you. My hope is in you. And my hope is in you alone.
Thank you.